Example 13. Oh, getting more and more difficult. Right? But never mind, let's try. Keyword here, exactly. If there's no exactly, just use GC. Correct? If there's no exactly, use GC. But now there's exactly. What do we do? Can I have attention, please? It is the square root that is irritating. And furthermore, it's the square root that's irritating, and furthermore, you have a subtraction within the square root. So, can we use the same trick as example 12a? Look, if I can use what is cosine x? I can simplify cosine x, or I shouldn't say simplify, I can change it into another form such that I don't have a subtraction anymore. What is this? I can let cosine x be equals to, recall, the same trick means what? What is cosine 2a? Equals to what? 1 minus 2 sine square a. Can we use the same trick here? Except now, I have cosine x. Now, x is 2a, so you half the x, which is x over 2. Can I write this? Can I write 1 minus 2 sine square? Can or cannot? Can. When we do that, then the 2 minus 2 goes. And on top of that, we actually get a sine square. Square root of 4 sine square x over 2. Okay, revision. What is square root of a square? Is it plus minus a mod a or a? Huh? Some of you say A, I'll tell you it's wrong. Because you think about it, if A is negative 8 or A is negative 2, A squared is 4, square root 4 is 2, you will not get back A. Correct? You will not get back A, so A is wrong. Who else? What are the answers? Plus minus A. Cannot be plus minus A. Because there's only one answer. Mod A. Okay, recall. But, there's a but, huh? If I tell you, A is positive, what is square root of A squared? A, because mod A, mod of a positive number will always be in itself. So, I have square root of sine square x over the 4, I can leave it, root 4 is just 2. Are we very sure that sine x over 2 is positive? Why? Sine can be negative, right? Are we very sure that sine x over 2 is positive? Not very sure, some of you say. Okay. Not very sure, right? Okay. I can tell you this. If there's no limits, then I'm not very sure. If there are no limits here, I really don't know whether sine x over 2 is positive or negative. Because x can take all numbers, all values. But now I have limits. Are you all talking when I'm talking? I say again, if there are no limits, I really don't know. But now they have limits, we have limits. That means you are integrating for a range of values of x that falls between pi and 3 pi over 2. You then have to ask yourself, for x between pi and pi, 3 pi over 2, is sine x over 2 positive or not? Can you be very sure? Can or cannot? Can.
Here, but I cannot find the laptop.
Hey, it's in my cupboard. In the locked cupboard is in my where I sit, right hand side.
Okay.
Okay, it's in the bottom. It's the bottom. You have the key. The key is hang there. The red one, the red one with string. Can? Can? Okay, thanks. Okay. Hey, copy. So we need to check if it's non-negative, okay? And we are quite sure. Yes, for those of us who need confirmation. Thank you. This is a sine graph, correct? And for x between pi and 3 pi over 2, x over 2 is between pi over 2 and 3 pi over 4. Correct? Correct? This is x over 2. This is pi over 2, sorry. This is 3 pi over 4. So this part is always positive. Correct? So now, we can safely take square root without the mod sign. And then we can integrate. Okay, the rest you can move faster than me, no problem. Okay, what is integral of x sine x over 2? Can I? Okay, there must be a 4 and a negative cosine x over 2. Don't believe you differentiate this, you see whether you get that. Okay, then the last line you go and work out and check answer with your friend. Exam form, very nice. Very nice exam form. Should be exam form. Work it out. What is cosine pi over 2? What is cosine 3 pi over 4? You tell me. Okay, come.
First, I need a calculator.
Yes.
Cosine is 0.
Zero?
Pi
0.
Cosine 0.707,
which is exact form, please. Exact form. Exact form, please. Negative. Or be. Yeah. Yeah, you could. Yeah, you're not remembering, man. That's why I say you don't need to remember. Fine, yeah, agree. Only for a product to there, lah. But some of us are not comfortable with the negative 2x. Can or not? What is sine negative x?
Just minus sine x.
Sine cosine negative x.
Cosine x.
So you must know, lah. Yeah, lah, you know, lah. But it's not so obvious to some of us, you know. Huh? Fine. Can. Take out, what do you mean by take out? Okay, can you answer me first? How do you integrate this one, without the two. Divide by half. Correct. Hey, answer. Answer. What's the answer?
I never do yet.
Talk, talk, talk. Hey, answer. Don't know. Hello. What is? Wait. This one. Cosine pi over 2 is 0. As easy as that. So there's you minus 0. What is cosine 3 pi over 4? Minus 1 over 2. So minus minus you get positive. So 1 over 2. So 4 over 2. Correct. If I want to be a bit more precise, can I rationalize this? 2 root 2, done.